Valentine's to each and everyone. I hope you are having a good Monday start after the New Year and Valentine weekend. So for today's episode, it's going to be grains and grains specifically in our diet and if we can really live without it, no? So tayo as Filipinos, especially in a bigger term as Asians, we were brought up, pinalaki tayong kumakain ng kanin, kumakain kung hindi man ng kanin, we have other alternatives like corn and of course other sources of grains which would include flour or wheat flour. So all its byproducts including bread, including ano pa ba, corn chips, pastries, all of these are actually byproduct of grains. So whenever we say grains, these are a group of plants, no? Na actually, yung grain na ito is actually a seed. So it's a seed of that specific plant. So we will tackle it one by one. What are the different kinds of grains? At saka kung ano-ano ang mga nandito sa atin available in the Philippines and how is it important to know them and do we really need to avoid them ba? No? So we have a lot of our members here, especially the ones who are already viewing. If not first timers, I know you are well aware of our group, Life Without Rice. So you can say, no, you can think, how come is it possible? Is it really possible to live without rice? We've been in this way of life for quite a long time. Sabi natin na we have us in the family even to a personal experience now. More than 2 years na kaming hindi nagsasaing. Yes, we never ever cooked rice again for our own consumption. Although there are very, very rare occasions that we cook them. Say for example, if we have an event in our cafe here, in our Tambayanihan Garden Cafe, when one client specifically asked to have rice as a side dish. So we cook that. But for our consumption, hindi na talaga kami, never na kami intentionally nakakain or kumain or nagsaing ng rice specifically. And bakit natin kailangan gawin ito? Do you also think you can benefit from a life without rice or a life without grains in general? Why is it something na pinopromote natin? And what are the benefits of having a rice-less lifestyle or a grain-free lifestyle? Ano ang pwede nating makuha dito? So before we proceed, I would like to greet Richelle Pagaduan Domingo and of course Mama Regina Bumanglag. Hello, thank you so much, one of our moderators in Life Without Rice and Low Carb Feasting and Fasting Community. So if you have questions, kung hindi man ako agad-agad makasagot, don't worry, we have our own moderators. We have Chloe, we have Cherise, we have Icy, we have Elise, and of course, my brothers, Andrew and Alvin, a lot of them. And even my mom, no, moderator then, but more on the silent type of moderator. Pero if you have questions, if you have concerns, especially for newbies, for beginners, na sa Life Without Rice, and Low Carb Nutrition, Feasting and Fasting Community natin, just ask any questions at all, anything that's been possibly boggling you, mga things that you are very concerned of. Sometimes hindi masyadong obvious, and as we go along day to day, merong mga questions na nagpo-pop up. So I think before I logged in a couple of hours ago, I saw one post na nagtatanong, is it okay ba to exercise while fasting for more than 24 hours? So I said, it's up to you. So pwedeng-pwede yan. There are a lot of experienced fasters na sanay mag-exercise. So it's a matter of what your body can do, what you feel you can do, and what your body is used to. So it's a matter of getting used to something. Hindi pwedeng agad-agad. So since ako hindi talaga ako masyado nag-exercise by nature, not as routinely as most people. So kapag nagpa-fasting ako, I try to minimize my movements on only to essential ones. So hindi ako nagkakaroon ng extra unnecessary movements since hindi talaga kailangan. Whereas my sister, she is very very always present yan sa gym. So sanay siya mag-exercise. So the first time actually that she did 7 days water only fasting, she was still working out every day, 1 to 2 hours. That's a moderate to high intensity workout. So it's up to you, kanya-kanya yan. So malalaman mo eventually if you're young to it. And my other cousins even who are very athletic, who are swimmers by since they were young, sanay na sanay sila mag swimming, continue swimming in the, even on a fasted state. So I'm happy that they've now incorporated fasting in their lifestyle. At nakita rin nila yung benefit nito. But for this afternoon, we will focus more not on fasting, but on low-carb nutrition. And one very, very important na core disciplines when it comes to low-carb lifestyle is actually the removal of grains. No? So we have different grains, we have different grain alternatives na kinoconsider ng iba na healthier. So we have the likes of quinoa, meron pang ano nga yung isa na parang ano yun, couscous, ano nga yun, ano, merong isang pang grain na parang yun yung pinopromote especially for diabetics kasi sabi nga nila low glycemic index ito. So if one food is considered as low glycemic index, safe na ba itong kainin when it comes to low carb lifestyle? So we will tackle that one by one. Before we proceed, I would like to say hi to Eleanor Papio Carranza. Nar Sensei, hello Doc. Sobra kitang sinishare sa family and friends ko. God bless you always. Thank you so much. I hope nakarating na yung books. I think you've ordered a book and I'm so happy na we get to have our talk last time. And I hope that it will benefit you and your family. And looking forward to your results too. So, Abu Sakina Madia, the Piton. Happy Valentine's. Happy Valentine's. So, hindi ba namin nakuha yung Valentine's namin na mga hearts namin, no? So, we will rearrange after this. And mind you, I'm still on dry fasting. Currently going 19 hours of dry fasting. I'm not sure if I'm gonna break it. So, baka ituloy ko na lang until tomorrow. We will see. Okay? Emily Dugenyo. Happy Valentine's. Joe Laksamana, hello po. Maraming salamat po. You are as beautiful po. Thank you so much for always being there. Verhel Maravilla, can LCIF cure dizziness and vertigo? So, dizziness and vertigo is actually under my specialty since I am an ENT by specialty, no? Yun talaga yung na-train ko. Being a general physician first, I went into training and I'm now a graduated last December 31 lang. Graduate tayo under the ENT, ears, nose, throat, technical term, otorhinolaryngology, head and neck surgery. So one of those is actually part yon ay dizziness and vertigo. So generally, binibigay namin yan ng prescription. Usually, yung pinaka-cause niyan is hindi talaga malaman unless meron yung iba na may mga tumor or yung iba meron talagang known, no, na labyrinthitis or infection sa loob ng tenga natin. But for many episodes of vertigo and dizziness, actually, walang tayong nalalamang exact reason. So, we usually prescribe a lot of parang tinatawag namin shotgun medications. So, those medications are given to counter vertigo or to address the balance disorder. So, some of those acts on sa brain talaga natin, yung iba sa ears lang natin. But there are other current arising na theories, no, na vertigo and dizziness pala sometimes even can be alleviated by intake of antihistamine or steroids kasi meron siyang pathophysiology or cause niya na somewhat related na nagre-react na parang allergy na although it is really not allergy but yung mechanism niya, how it occurs, is somewhat related to allergy that it even seen, no? It was even seen to improve whenever anti-allergic meds medications were given. So with that, we can see talaga that to lower the inflammation, to lower the allergic response of the body can certainly possibly improve vertigo and dizziness. I have experienced it myself. I've seen some of the patients do it, the ones that consult with me because of ear problems, including vertigo, dizziness, and even some neuropathic pain or yung mga pain sa tenga na pain sa ibang parte ng katawan na hindi mo mawari kung saan nang galing. So, they were given a lot of medicines already. Sobrang taas na yung iba, anti-anxiety na, no, anxiolytic drugs. Some are even anti-convulsant like pregabalin, all those are very, very high level of drugs na talaga at sobrang mamahal pa. But whenever they started low carb lifestyle, no, low carb nutrition and fasting lifestyle, all those inflammation somewhat slowly decrease na talaga over time. Of course, it may not happen overnight, no, although there are some, no, na experience talaga a lot of relief, especially with unknown aches and pains in the body, even just an overnight fast or even just a day of withdrawal of grains in the diet. Wala mo ng kanin, wala mo ng rice, wala mo ng bread for 24 hours. The morning after the usual aches and pains, yung hirap sa pagbangon, biglang nawawala. Especially mga mommies natin, daddies, uncles, aunties, no? Nakikita talaga na parang yung sinasabi natin, akala natin, yung aches and pains, yung hirap sa pagbangon is already somewhat normal na tinatanggap na natin na part ng pagtanda. However, nakita natin na it's not the case pala. It's just a matter of lowering the inflammation in the body. It's just a matter of lowering the unnecessary load na binibigay sa katawan natin so that it will eventually normalize because our body is dying to heal itself. Gustong-gusto niyang gumaling. It's just that hindi niya ito basta-basta magawa because it's always busy digesting the foods that we've been feeding it. So, I don't know about you, but kami, for the last few days, we have an event here in our cafe, so a lot of food, although we try to stick with low carb talaga, but still a lot of food, especially when you are already used to OMAD, especially when you're used to eating one meal a day, or even parang half meal a day lang minsan. Kapag when you've eaten, I think my friend Chloe have just posted it recently, when your body is so used to OMAD or one meal a day, eating two meals a day already feels like too heavy or too much for you. Na the next day after, the morning after, you will feel a certain difference na talaga. Na parang merong mabigat, merong parang hindi sakto sa iyong katawan. So, yun nga yung sinabi natin, no? Whenever you feel sick, whenever like you feel like something is off, no? Na parang merong hindi maganda, hindi saktong pagbangon, merong hindi, parang you're generally feeling not yourself or feeling sick, try to do a 24-hour food recall. And for some na medyo mahina yung metabolism, you can even go as far as 48 to 72 hours of food recall. Chances are, nasobran ka sa pagkain, either ng bad carbs, ng mga carbohydrates na sugar-loaded, or if not, yung bad kind of cholesterol or bad kind of fats, which includes hydrogenated oils, yung mga artificial oils, margarine, vegetable oils, corn oil, yung lahat ng mga oil na hindi talaga naturally healthy for us to consume. So, before we move on, basa muna tayo ng konti. Good PM po, Doc. Natapos ko na po ang book. Wow, thank you so much, Jess. So glad I ended my 36 hours of fasting kanina 9 a.m. Tama ka, Doc. More on psychological exercise battle ito. Hindi ako nagutom ng bongga. Far from my thoughts na baka magkasakit ako sa gutom. See, I told you, sobrang ganda. This is what I really feel so, so happy about. Whenever I know one, no, na nakatapos ng magbasa ng libro, they can go, once you've finished reading, you can easily go into your first 24 hours fasting. For those more experienced, first 3 days of fasting, even first 5 or 7 days of fasting. Because, mind you, yung katawan natin, ready-ready yan sa fasting. But it is our mind, it is our mental process that needs to be ready. So those books, especially book 1 and book 2, yun talaga I designed to cater those mindset, no? To change our mindset for the better. Para when you go into fasting or kahit hindi ka man nagpa-fasting, but kung merong episode na hindi ka biglang nakakain kasi na-busy ka or kung anong na-stranded ka or whatever, for whatever reason, you won't feel bad. You are protecting your mental health simply because you know that your body can actually afford to fast. And I'm so happy for you, Jess. Way to go. I'm planning my extended fasting this 2021. At the end of February. So, chill lang kayo dyan. Magpapataba muna ako ng konti ngayong araw at ngayong mga panahon before my extended fast because I want to do a longer fast than I did before. So, Ronald de Mayuga for 2. Hello, Dr. Grace. Salamat sa new learning. God bless. Watching from Singapore. Thank you so much, Bob. Singapore is one of the best place to visit, even for just a layover. Kasi sobra mong daming mapupuntahan in just a day or a few hours. Nakapag-workout pa po ako and nakapunta sa market si Jesta, ha, without eating. Sana maging okay po ang aking weight loss journey as I incorporate fasting as a way of life. Yes, I'm sure, no? And if you can, no, don't focus much on your weight now. Focus on your overall goal, or kung pwede nga lang, just focus on achieving your fasting goals one fasting at a time, okay? One day at a time. Eventually, your body will just normalize, your body will just attain its ideal state. So, Macantara Aloe Vera, happy doctor. Hi, Doctora. Happy Hearts Day to you. Happy Hearts Day, sir. I hope you can visit us here. I know you're just somewhere here nearby. So, Maven Gayares, hi, Doc. This is Doc. Is it okay for a diabetic who has maintenance oral meds and insulin injection to do fasting? Actually, fasting could be the easiest, quickest fix for those who are already dependent on insulin. However, sadly, hindi to, I don't recommend on anyone doing it on their own. No? Merong specific protocol. Kasi when you are already in insulin, the doctor who gave you that insulin injection already parang kinompute yan na. Computed already based on the under the presumption that you that the patient will be eating 3 meals a day. Minsan nga inaallow pa yung mga snacks in between. So if you want to do fasting, it is important that you also know how to do the necessary adjustment with insulin. So it's important that the current state of the patient, the current insulin dose, how long na ang patient naka-insulin, and of course, kung ano yung current niya na diet and how long can they fast. Because if ginagawin nito, the patient can go to either 2 very dangerous and important risks. So baka magkaroon siya ng episode ng hypoglycemia, which is already an emergency in itself. If it's a true hypoglycemia or sobrang baba ng sugar sa katawan, or diabetic ketoacidosis, or yung panahon na sobrang taas ng sugar sa katawan and also mataas din yung ketone sa katawan. So they shouldn't go together. So dapat pababain muna yung sugar to a normal level before we can incorporate fasting. So we encourage that if a patient is already on medications, kahit hindi pa insulin yan, before starting low-carb intermittent fasting lifestyle, kailangan magpa-consult muna with a doctor, a practitioner who is knowledgeable with low-carb lifestyle. So I myself is one. We also have Doc Fee Atencio. We also have Dr. Iggy Agbayani. And of course, Dr. Suzette. No? So there's 4 of us here in the Philippines currently practicing that. Although we have different schedules and medyo busy minsan, but we try to help and entertain online consultations, especially na mahirap magbiyahe ngayon. I hope that answers your question, and I hope you won't get discouraged because of those side effects. Pero kailangan talaga. It is important that if we do it, we have to do it right. But for a start, if you hindi pa sure ngayon, you can start with reading the books, no? So we have books 1 and 2 na dedicated talaga for fasting and low carb nutrition, specifically for healing. So better, I really advise my patients and my readers na are the ones who are asking na to read muna the book. What you can get from this video, listening to me in an hour, actually in 1 to 2 hours, mafi-finish mo na yung book. And it's already like maybe the whole videos that we have in our YouTube. Although we have new learnings from time to time, we have new discoveries that we incorporate, but the goal, the gist itself of low carb, the very gist of low carb nutrition and fasting lifestyle ay nandun na. So, Melanie, hello. I hope na narinig mo yung sagot natin kanina. Milet Aksaban, Mayelin Dimakulangan, I feel sick pagkagising ko po kaninang umaga because maybe eating 5 pieces of Kirkland almond nuts with coated chocolates, ayun, kasi nakatanggap ng Valentine's gift si Mayelin. Is this possible? Of course it is possible. Kagabi, kahapon, hindi ako nakakain ng chocolates. Wala na munang bigay ng chocolates sa amin. Kasi if we eat chocolates, actually, we use our intense dark compound chocolate. So that is about 70% to 75% na dark chocolate. So yun yung ginagawa namin glaze sa aming low-carb donut. So if we ever crave for chocolates, yun na lang, magme-melt na lang kami. So yesterday, hindi naman ako nakakain kasi we were busy with our grilled barbecue, pork barbecue, unlimited pork barbecue here. So yun lang din yung pinagkakain namin. Sir Ronnie, hello! Ang keto low carb nakasira ng kidney pag tumatagal. So far, walang direct evidence yan. Kung meron man, it is because the person was already having a kidney problem before pa siya nagka-start. No? So it is important to do. That's why if you are not sure if you are 100% at the top of your health, better to have an initial consultation first. No? We have baseline laboratories para generally ma-check muna so that we know what we need to watch out for. Like for my mom, you know na na-operahan siya last time with her gallbladder, kaya tinanggal ito because 5 years ago, she was already diagnosed with multiple gallbladder stones and bile sludge, no, sa gallbladder niya. So, for a while, we thought fasting would be enough, no, para mawala ito. And yes, it na indeed, hindi siya nagkaroon ng any symptoms while we were in our low carb and intermittent fasting and even extended fasting. However, nagka-episode siya, nag-block yung stone the moment she ate a high carb meal, no? High carb na may combine na high fat din. So that was the dangerous, the needed push, no, para maoperahan siya. But for those na meron na, like for example, merong mga renal stones or kidney stones, it's better actually na ma-address yon beforehand para hindi ma-complicate at hindi natin masisi yung innocenting low carb at fasting na wala namang kasalanan. But it's just that we already accumulated certain illnesses, certain malfunctions sa katawan natin given the decades long, no, na we've been unknowingly abused it. So hindi naman talaga natin sobrang inabuso na intentional. It was unintentional for most of us, especially when we are eating grain. So Verhel Maravilla, doc practicing LCIF since 2019, nawala craving, kaya ko mag-fasting 1 to 2 days. That's good. But my something nang nangyari sa akin noong 2020, may sudden panic and nakaramdam ako ng parang umuuga na feeling na naluluha ako. Pa-consult regarding vertigo and feeling dizzy. Salamat. Okay, you just send a message with my page, no? My clinic manager will assist you if you need to do consultation. So, we will see. Kasi baka, once you're already in your goal weight, kahit sanay na tayo mag-fasting, sometimes doing over-fasting is also not enough. Baka nagkaroon ka na ng electrolyte imbalance and at the same time, yun yung isa sa pinaka-common causes of vertigo actually. It's just the chemical imbalance. Kasi yung vertigo, yung internal inner ear natin, it's made up of parang yung helicotrema, yung parang ano yun, nautilus, ano yung parang shell, yung parang ganun siya. Tapos meron yung dapat na equal amount of certain electrolytes para yung electrochemical gradient niya or yung chemical charge niya is ganito lang dapat. But with electrolyte imbalance, kulang ng sodium, nasobraan ng potassium or whatever, nagkakaroon din siya ng manifestations. And that can manifest as dizziness or vertigo. So, Kathy Verdides, much love to you. Joanna Marie Aberin, hi, Doctora, so blessed with your life. May effect po bang fasting and low carb with hormonal imbalance, estrogen dominant po, resulting with endometriosis? Yes, very much, no? And sadly, with insulin resistance, the more it is being fed on estrogen-sensitive cells, no? So, mas lalo itong dumadami. Mas lalo itong lalala. So, with fasting actually is one of the first thing that can starve those unnecessary endometriosis, no? Yung mga endometrial lining tissue na pwedeng mawala. So, it's part estrogen dominant. Endometriosis is actually one of the symptoms of insulin resistance. So, if magpapa-laboratory ka, if you can have an insulin checkup, no? Level of insulin checkup or CRP or ano yan? C-reactive protein level, which can see, no, it can detect the amount of inflammation in your body, which is usually related to insulin. If indirect measurement of insulin, you can see na mataas yan. So you can really benefit from fasting. If you want to fast on healing, I suggest you read the book one first, no? Book one, Perfect at Last Weight, yun lang yung title niya. But it is actually a weight loss, but a fasting protocol. You can use the protocol there, both for weight loss and for healing, especially tumors and certain masses, no? It can be benign or cancer. So hello, Sir Romel Reyes. Thank you so much for tagging your friend. And Juliet Guritan Mendoza, good evening. Mildred Bernardina Maliari, hello. Silent reader here po from Dubai. Hello po, I love Dubai. Yung Dubai, yung sabi nila, it's the Disneyland for adults kasi sobrang ganda. Just wanna ask if normal po ba yung bumababa ang BP pag nag-low carb? Yes, certainly, because it will not already hold on to too much salt and water in your body. So, magkakaroon ka ng water and salt losing, which is kung mababa na yung mababa na yung BP mo to start, it might lead to hypotension, no? Or yung sobrang pababa. So, biglang pagtayo, medyo nahihilo, which is something na nangyayari sa amin because mababa talaga yung blood pressure namin normally. Normally, blood pressure namin on a normal day is 90 to over 60, no? But that is also the reason why hypertensives, the ones na mga matataas yung BP, can really benefit from the natural lowering of blood sugar na effect ng low carb and fasting. What you can improve on is if sobrang baba na talaga, you can do some exercises and most importantly, increase your salt intake, okay? Your salt intake is necessary kasi if hindi nagbago yung salt intake mo, chances are you've been eating way lower salt than you actually need, no? By guidelines, usually nililimit nila to 1,000 to 1,500 lang na milligrams. So that is just around 1/4 of a teaspoon. But in low carb, we actually recommend 1 to 2 teaspoons. No? So that's actually 4,500 to 9,000 milligrams of salt. No? And as long as your body is, as long as your kidney is still functioning well, no problem yan. Not a cause of worry because it will be the one that's needed. Kasi magkakaroon ka talaga ng salt losing mechanism kapag naglo-low carb ka because it is the insulin that dictates your body to hold on to those water and extra salt sa katawan natin. So, kapag nag-low carb ka, especially for the first time, you will feel like grabe yung ihi mo during the first 18 hours going 20 hours because those are the excess water that your body has been hanging on to for the longest time. Okay? Doc, salamat na ma-resolve po yung nararamdaman ko. Okay, Malu Gloria Valencia Santelices, watching from Quezon City. Hello po, Doc. Hi, Doc. And looking forward on our next consultation. Yes, I know. Meron tayong follow-up consultation and I really pray that you've improved from the last time, although you are already on the right track. So usually, yung usual patients natin are already the ones with experience with low carb and fasting, but needed na lang a little polishing, you know, finishing touches na lang, just to correct those little mga hindi mawaring kung anong difference sa laboratory results natin. But mostly, you're on your way into healing. So, hope to see you here in Dubai. Hopefully, we can visit again. No? Supposedly nga, may visit kami dyan last year. So, hindi lang natuloy. But all is well in the end. So, kung hindi pa well, it's not yet the end. So, hintay-hintay lang tayo. Edsel Elaine Gutierrez. Hi, Doc. We'll be starting tomorrow. Wow, thank you so much. And Len Castro, also watching from Dubai. Magkakaroon na talaga ng maramihang low-carb Dubai, no? Low-carb Dubai convention. Hopefully, magkaroon tayo ng ganyan. But, mauubos yung oras natin, but because our episode right now is actually dedicated for grains, no? To clarify, the grains, whenever we say grains, it would include rice, kahit white rice, brown rice, black rice, red rice, lahat ng rice ay grain. So, kung merong sasabi sa'yo, so, hindi na nga ako nagre-rice ngayon, brown rice na lang. So, that is still rice, okay? Or kung sabihin man, black rice na ngayon, so, mas grabe yun. Parang intense na, feeling mo, sobrang healthy ka na. Sabi mo, black rice na, no? So, but it will still be rice in the end. In the end, kapag na-process na ng katawan natin, whether it's coming from black rice, white rice, red rice, brown rice, at kung ano pa, or it's a bread, wheat flour, kahit whole wheat flour pa yan, or corn kernel, full corn kernel, corn chips, at lahat-lahat ng yan, it is still considered as grains, no? And all the grains are made up of carbohydrates. Of course, meron siyang part na protein kapag kakainin mo yung husk niya or yung germ layer niya. But of course, it won't add up much nutrition as compared to, say, for example, kakain ka ng totoong high protein rich, which is high bioavailable para sa atin, which includes pagkain ng karne, pork, chicken, beef, even those sinasabi natin, kinakatakutan nating pork, no, baboy. And quinoa, yes, adlay and quinoa, yun yung ngayon na parang nauuso. So adlay and quinoa, in the end, they are still grains, okay? But what they will differ on is the tawag natin ang glycemic index nila. So, when I want to explain it to my patient, so, if ang white rice, kapag kumain ka, yung glycemic index mo, ganon, shoot up agad. So, the moment you eat it, ang tataas agad yung insulin mo, and it will cause immediate lowering down of your blood sugar. Or, if you're insulin resistant, so, hindi pa rin siya magkakaroon ng immediate na lowering ng yung blood sugar, but it will lead to matagal na pag-stay ng insulin sa katawan mo. And all those effects, always natin na-discuss yan, can lead to inflammation, tumor formation, allergies, fat production, at saka hindi paggamit ng taba sa katawan natin. It will be on fat storing mode, fat deposition mode. So, yun yung ginagawa ng insulin natin. Yung adlay, quinoa, black rice, brown rice, they're actually still carbohydrates. It's just that it is highly incorporated with fiber. So, ano ang ginagawa ng fiber? So, yung ginagawa ng fiber, dinedelay niya yung pag-absorb ng pagkain sa katawan natin. So, instead of shooting up that way, so, hinay-hinay. Kasi hinay-hinay. But overall, yung 50 grams mo na 50 grams na net carbs, ah, when we talk about na kung isipin natin total net carbs, yung 50 grams mo na net carbs, kahit pa hinay-hinay yan, eventually, it will still peak. Ah, at kapag nag-peak yan, magkakaroon pa rin siya ng same insulin effect. So, it is important to differentiate between glycemic index and insulin index. Hindi lahat ng mababang insulin ang glycemic index ay mababa rin yung insulin index because we are actually more concerned in lowering the insulin effect in our body rather than just focusing on the glycemia or the glucose because in the end, yung insulin talaga ang nagdidictate kung ano ang mangyayari sa katawan natin. So, for those who are considering kung ano yung mga pagkain na low in glycemic index or GI index and low in insulin index or II index, yun yung mga pagkain na halos walang carbohydrates at punong-puno ng fiber. So, ano ito? So, para siyang hirap if isipin natin. But these are actually very, very much abundant everywhere. So, yung talbos ng kung ano-ano, talbos ng kamote, talbos ng sili, talbos ng malunggay, talbos ng ano pa ba, ng mga kung ano, anything green leafy vegetables are the highest form of nutritionally dense foods, maraming nutrition, maraming vitamins and minerals, with the highest amount of fiber but lowest amount in calories coming from carbohydrates. So, those vegetables, those green leafy ones are actually what we call as parang you can eat all you can. Eat unlimited, no? Kasi wala siyang effect when it comes to our body, when it comes to our insulin, okay? And mind you, yung fiber actually, noon, pinalaki tayo na it is very much needed, it's very much essential, kasi yun yung nagkakapag-push ng bowel natin. So, it's a technical difficulty a while ago, medyo nagkakaroon talaga ng problem from time to time. But anyway, moving on around about our topic, grain free, no? The grains in our diet. Why do we need to avoid it? Because first, this is not natural for our way of life. It is something na hindi na sana yung katawan natin because our body has been so used to having a real food, no? Real nutrition coming from animal meat, coming from greens, no? Na available for the last 2 million years. And the grains, the rice, the wheat, the corn, no? All of these agricultural produce is just available, was made available only for the last 2,000 years na hindi pa rin nasana yung katawan natin. So I think merong mga questions a while ago on the other video. We would like to answer that before we end. So meron doon, how about oat groats po? So oat groats are still grains, but it is what we considered as whole kernel. So, nandyan lahat. So, if you eat plain instant oatmeal, for example, of course, the oat groat is much better. It's much healthier given that maliit lang yung carbohydrate content niya because mataas yung fiber content niya, okay? So, but in the end, it will still be the same na carbohydrate kapag marami yung kinakain natin. The difference kasi, yung tendency kasi natin, for example, when we eat adlay or when we eat quinoa, instead of, although mas konti yung net carbs niya as compared to rice, for example, na white rice, But minsan, merong tendency yung mga kumakain na kasi alam nila na mas konti yung net carbs, they also tend to overeat it. So, yung end result, parang pareho lang din. It's just that I want to emphasize that grains is not essential. Meaning, mabubuhay talaga tayo. We can live without grains. We can live without rice, without wheat, without bread, without flour. It's just that we are so used to it. Nasanay lang tayo and our body is already craving it. Kasi nga, by nature, we only tend to eat sugar during harvest season. So, meron tayong innate tendency to maximize and consume sugar whenever it's available. Under the presumption that sugar is made available only once in a year, no? During harvest season lang. But right now, hindi pa alam ng katawan natin, ng DNA natin, na ang pagkain pala ay available na all throughout the year, na we already don't need to fast. Pero siya, akala niya, meron pa rin fasting season na magaganap. That's why we are promoting, we are actually trying to share, no, the knowledge that it is even helpful and helpful to incorporate intentional fasting sa araw-araw natin, okay? So, what are the other questions there? So, the oats, no? It has low glycemic index, but it certainly has, it is not low in insulin index. So, the only ones that are low in insulin index are those foods na hindi so sobra sa 5 grams. 5 grams ang net carbs per 100 gram na capacity. So, if you check those oats, no? Kung ang regular oats, say for example, around 80 grams yung net carbs niya. And as compared to whole rolled oats or yung mga oat groats or yung mga whole wheat or mga ganyan, it can lower down into 40, 50, or 60 grams per 100 gram. But that is still way, way too high. If i-compare mo ito with, say for example, kale or spinach or malunggay, no, na ang isang buong 100 grams ng malunggay, yung net carbs na siguro niyan baka 1 or 2, very very negligible because it is fully loaded with fiber and other nutrient dense na nutrients, vitamins and minerals na walang calorie. So, hello! Salamat na nandito kayo ulit. So, Chloe, this is already part 2. Nakahabol ka. Kasi na-stop yung first episode, the first part of this. That's quite a long episode already. We are actually about to finish this one. But before I finish, I want to give a little good news para sa mga nandito ngayon about na mga taong hindi talaga makalet go ng rice o yung mga sobrang namimiss nila yung rice. So I myself, hindi ko talaga namimiss yung rice because even before discovery of low carb nutrition, no, hindi talaga ako mahilig sa kanin. Mas mahilig ako sa other kanin alternatives, which would include yung mga pansit, bihon, sotanghon, yung mga ganyan. So, all those noodles, no? So, kahit hindi mo kami nag-practice ng Chinese culture sa pamilya namin, but something about noodles talaga and ramen na gustong-gusto ko. So, but the rice itself, wala akong pakialam. I can live without it. But there is a hack. And I don't usually promote this kasi nakaka-confuse siya, especially sa mga newbies, sa mga beginners pa lang when it comes to low carb nutrition. But if you are here watching and you've been watching since kanina, I'm quite sure, no, na you already have an idea how to do low carb, no? So para sa mga more experienced faster, more experienced low carber, I would like to introduce the concept of resistant starch, no? So resistant starch is the mechanism, is the starch, no? It's a kind of carbohydrate na hindi na da-digest ng katawan natin. So it will just pass on. Dadaan lang siya sa ating gastrointestinal tract na hindi siya ma-absorb. Meaning, it will be very low in glycemic index. It will also be very low in insulin index kasi nga hindi siya matutunaw. So it will be those foods usually na mga hilaw. So, for example, flour, tapioca flour or yung cassava flour. So, yung cassava na hilaw, meron yung flour-like. If kakainin mo yan, it will become a resistant starch. So, other people can benefit from it. Like, they put a teaspoon or a tablespoon of raw hilaw na tapioca flour and it is make your rice into a resistant starch. So, ready the part 3 of our live episode. Medyo i-enar ka yung connection natin ngayon. But I hope you get to hear about resistant starch, no? And our hack, no? Kung gusto talaga makakain ng rice. So, the concept is, kapag kumain ka ng rice na nag-overnight rice, we call them overnight rice, and we serve them here in Tambayanihan Cafe, no? Yung overnight rice, it will cut the carbohydrate content, the net carbs, into 50%. So, instead of consuming 50%, 50 for example, 40 grams of net carbs, of carbohydrate, of sugar in a cup of rice, magiging 20 na lang ito. So you can save, no? And if you just still eat half cup only, so parang 1/4 cup lang yung nakain mo. So you can easily put that in a budget. So pwede mo siyang ipasok sa budget mo na 20 grams per day or 50 grams per day. So, before na pa maulit na mawala yung internet connection natin, I would like to say goodbye and thank you, of course, no? At maraming salamat, my dearest Eleanor and Sir Ronnie, na nandyan agad-agad kahit pangatlong transfer na natin ito sa ating video. Sobrang love ko talaga kayo. I hope you will be able to finish this, and I hope you get to share your experiences as well. I know mahirap yung life without rice to start, but if you want to improve your health, rice is worth letting go. If you want to have your health as the result, as the reward, no? And the life of health, and the life of activity, and the life of longevity, no? Para sa'yo, para sa sarili mo, and your loved ones, and the cause that you believe in. Yun lang muna for now. I hope you get to finish this. Thank you so much in advance, EJ, and of course, Mona. I hope you are enjoying your Valentine's, and we can extend the Valentine week, no? We don't need to wait for Valentine's to show our love to ourselves and our loved ones. We can do it every day for the whole year, and we can do that by first, no? Fasting as long as we can, and if we can't fast, always stay low carb so that when we do eat, we are safe all the time. Supplier yata ng rice yung ISP nyo. Oo nga, no? Baka nalalaman nila. Galing talaga daw. LJ Linda, looking great. Mary Sembas, Puig County, Janela, Salvador. Ay, nako. Ganun ba? Mahiya naman ako. Maraming salamat po. Bye-bye for now. Thank you, EJ. Thank you, Claude, Charisse, and my dear mommy, and my brothers and sisters. I love you all. Maraming salamat po. Thank you so much for always watching. See you again this coming Wednesday. Also, still here in my page, Dr. Josephine Grace Chua Rojo. And if you want to have a copy of the book, you can just send me a message. Or if you want to schedule a consultation, online consultation, I am available every Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays. Princess Punzalan, for me, ikaw talaga, ma. Ikaw lang nakakita niyan. Sige po, maraming salamat. Till next time. Bye-bye.